a short presentation on the topic pedagogy. Pedagogy, definition, meaning and origin. Pedagogy is the art, science or profession of teaching. It is defined simply as the method and practice of teaching. Method and practice, sorry. Pedagogical approaches, differences in the age of pupils and the content being delivered can influence the pedagogical practice a teacher will choose to use. Behaviorism, constructivism, social constructivism, and liberationism. Behaviorist pedagogy uses the theory of behaviorism in its approach. A behaviorist pedagogical approach would say learning is teacher-centered. Theory of behaviorism in classroom setting came from pedagogical research by Thorndike, Pavlov, and Skinner. Constructivism, it is a theory that advocates that people learn through experiences and reflection. A constructivist approach would incorporate project work, inquiry-based learning, and might adopt a Montessori method. Means project work, inquiry-based learning, and Montessori method. Constructivism is based on the pedagogical research of Piaget. Constructivism is also sometimes described as a progressive teaching style. Social constructivism. A social constructivism pedagogy could be considered to be a blend of two priorities, teacher-guided and student-centered. Teacher-guided and student-centered. Lev Vygotsky developed social constructivism. Lev Vygotsky. Okay. The teacher might also use teacher modeling, questioning, and a mixture of individual, pair, and whole class instruction. Liberationism. It is a critical pedagogy. Critical pedagogy is important. Developed by the Brazilian educator Paulo Freire. He wrote a book called Pedagogy of the Oppressed. Pedagogy of the Oppressed. Student may take on the role of the teachers and decide upon the topic of the lesson. In this pedagogy, the teacher should provide space and opportunity for the students to showcase. The term open pedagogy has a long history. Now we are talking about OER-enabled pedagogy, that is Open Educational Resources-enabled pedagogy. Dufin argues that open pedagogy is a philosophy in which the content of the course as well as its progress is determined by the needs and preferences of participants. Needs and preferences of participants. Williams and Gray use the term to refer to the opening up of educational processes enabled by web. Okay. Now web 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 technology. Web 2 technology is the term used to describe a variety of websites and applications that allow anyone to create and share online information or material they have created. Web 1 means developing the internet. Web 0, Web 1, read-only web. web 2 writing and participating web, web 3 read, write and execute web. Web 4 means mobile web, connect all devices in the real and virtual world in real time. Web 5 means open, linked and intelligent web, that is emotional web. We have to understand that what is the meaning of open here. It indicates that these materials are licensed with copyright licenses that provide permission for everyone to participate in the 5R activities. Willy describes the 5Rs in more detail. These are retain, reuse, revise, remix and redistribute. Let's talk about each one. Retain means the right to make, own and control copies of the content. Make, own and control copies. Reuse means the right to use the content. Right to use the content. Revise means the right to adapt, adjust and modify. Remix means the right to combine the original or revised content. Redistribute means the right to share copies of the original content. It can be understood that OER gives permission to its users to use that material in any way as described above, but has to give due credit to the original. Now, what are the reasons behind emergence of this new pedagogy? First one is new demands of a knowledge-based society. New student expectations. New technologies which have been evolved so fast. Blended learning, which is the call of the hour, that is proper blending of online and offline learning. Collaborative approaches to the construction of knowledge. Building communities of practice. Another one is the use of multimedia and open educational resources. Increased student control. Choice and independence means pedagogy now becomes student-centered. They can learn by their own. Anywhere, anytime, any size learning. New forms of assessment. Digital learning can leave a permanent trace in the form of student contributions to online discussion and e-portfolios of work through the collection, scoring and assessment of a student's multimedia. And at last, self-directed and non-formal online learning, that is in which comes OERs and MOOCs. MOOCs, that is massive open online courses, field of educational technology and higher education. Thus, in this way, we can say that this is the concept of pedagogy, its various approaches and the reasons for the emergence of a new pedagogy, which is the call of the hour in this new global world. This new pedagogy has attained its momentum in this COVID period. Thank you. Let me pause this.